We interviewed over 800 people, specifically not within IT, so business decision makers and senior execs within the organization, to get an understanding of what they thought their risks were and what value they put on data security within their business. The key findings in the report really were quite surprising. Nearly two-thirds of an organization expected to have a security breach at some point in the future, which is probably backed up by industry analysts and certainly a lot of the headlines that you're seeing. But less than 10% saw data security as the greatest risk to their business. Our research showed, and it's actually very interesting when you look at those statistics, so nearly three-quarters of senior execs said that insurance is vital. When you actually dig into that data, though, then less than half actually say they've got cover for data security or an information security breach. Most organizations actually feel that their insurance, their business insurance, covers them from cybersecurity. What we've seen, certainly with a lot of the recent headlines and a lot of our research, is that cybersecurity and that general business security isn't covering them. So we need to look at their critical assets. We need to understand what a data breach would mean to them, and actually from our perspective, from NTT Com Security's perspective, help them understand what those critical assets are and put the right control measures around it so they can actually then determine what they're insuring against. I think, yeah, from an insurance sector perspective, there's still a lot of ambiguity on what are we covering and what our liabilities are. If you look at any other insurance industry, there's a lot of actuarial data that they rely on to actually set those premiums and understand what they're covering. Cybersecurity, surprisingly from my perspective, is still very new. Organizations have looked at their business insurance and they think that's covering them. But actually, what we found with a lot of high-profile cases recently, that's simply not the fact. I think we're reaching that tipping point within information security at the moment where we need to take a different approach. We need to embrace the fact that individuals need to take responsibility for this and educate them in what they're doing and stop constraining them. And we've spent a long time bolting on technologies, constraining people in what they can do, rather than enabling business to embrace that technology change and work with our employees to protect that data and make them aware of that change. I think there's a cultural change that needs to take place as well. And again, within the industry, we need to be aware of that and start to changing. We've spent a long time trying to react faster. That clearly isn't working. If we look at the responsibility individuals take as well, again, looking at the statistics within the report, highlights the fact that individually we put the blame on somebody else, or we actually don't take that responsibility because we say, well, technology will protect us. Clearly that's not working, and we've seen that within the report, and we've seen that in other reports that we've done, that we will see a breach. People are looking at it that way, analysts are certainly looking at it that way, but it doesn't actually have to take that form. We can take proactive steps now. We can look at how we embrace with partnerships and collaboration. We can look at skill shortages as well, which is very important to a lot of organizations at the moment, of how we bring in a different culture within an organization when we're employing people to actually take them through that journey of embracing information security and risk management. I think the key takeaway from me is to really emphasize what this really means to a business. And I think despite the headlines and the value and the statistics we see out of the report, is that still businesses are underestimating the impact of a data breach on their organization, their bottom line, not only in terms of stock price and brand and their reputation, but actually the internal cost as well. What does it mean to individuals? And how does that impact their business and their working lives? And to see that collaboration take place, I think, again, we need to see a shift in the mindsets from a lot of organizations to say that we're all responsible for data protection. We're all responsible for our business, and to actually make sure that they understand that data is important. No matter where that data is, it should be secured, and we're all responsible for that.